Hey peeps. So hey to the peeps ring.
Hi.
Shan, she don't want to be on camera.
But you did it anyway, of course.
Can you say hey to the peeps, no. Lady? She still got work to do. That's not nice, Shan.
Yeah,
I'm finna come over there and kiss you all in your face. No. Give me kissy, 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 kissy. Come here, Shan. Say hey to the peeps. Say hey to the peeps. So, yeah, Rena getting ready to make my body wash, y'all. And we put it in this. Let me cut the light on. I'm gonna let Shan be.
Thanks.
You want the funnel?
No.
You don't need the funnel? Mm-hmm. Why buy that soap? And that's my body wash bottle right there, that brown bottle. And she put honey in it. And we're gonna put some almond oil in it. It smells real good. I got this off of Amazon. Great value, y'all already know where that came from. That's enough.
I know.
But you gotta put some honey in it. And.
Wait.
Really? And I got this peppermint Castile soap from Vitamin Shoppe. I forgot how much it costs. I done had it for a while, though. Yeah, so. She getting ready to make her some deodorant. And this is the candle essential oil she gonna put in there.
Mm-hmm.
What is that?
Sunflower.
Sunflower. I got this off of Amazon, too. So that's what she's gonna make after she finished making my body wash. These are my little essential oils. Eucalyptus. Rosemary. I got, a bottle. Cause I have two. They ain't asked us to make her none in a while. I want to miss you bad now. Check out my other ones. Basil. Frankincense. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Frankincense. Think of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Myrrh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You think of the Bible. Frankincense and myrrh. It have a funny smell. I haven't used it yet, but I looked up what it's good for. It's good for like aches and pains and all that type of stuff. So yeah, hey peeps, how y'all doing today? Today is April the 6th at 11:15 in the a.m. Thursday. It's Thursday. Today our last day. Whoop, 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 whoop. When spring break, She just ain't through with her work. That's why she over there having issues. Cause Rena through. She still got math to do, drawing to do.
I did those
too. Oh, you did.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. But in the meantime, in between time, today is a half a day.
Yeah.
It's our half a day today, too, so.
Nah,
yeah. I was going to do a read, but I don't feel like it. So this just going to be, you know, just a whatever video. Just talking to my peeps today. Yeah. I'll be back Saturday probably with my The Power of a Praying Wife read. My grandbabies come over tomorrow. Ain't no school tomorrow. Then we'll be on spring break. Yes! y'all, man. I think I'm more excited. Y'all, I think I'm more excited about spring break than the kids. Is that because we fasting? But our fasting gonna probably go pretty fast. And then we start Sunday night. We finish Friday evening, sort of kind of like once we eat dinner, it's over with. And then Saturday, what day that is? Not this Saturday coming up, but the 14th, we're going to see. What's the name of this Fast one? Yeah. Furious. It's just called Fast and Furious. What you saying?
Fate of the Furious.
It's called Fate of the Furious. I gotta do her hair. I did she in here. I don't think she wanna show y'all right now though, cause she got work to do. But I did it last night. I just twisted it all over. You gonna show the piece your hair when you finish?
Yeah.
You funny shit. you ain't right. Why you gonna treat the peeps like that? What have they done to you? They ain't do none to you. Oh, wow. But anyway, I bought Reno. I went to JCPenney yesterday. And it's time for me to start they starting to have their little dresses out for like the spring and graduations and stuff. Cause I've been looking, but they ain't have them out yet. So I got, she picked out her dress. Let's show the peeps your dress before you start making your deodorant.
Come on.
And tell the peeps what you use to make your deodorant.
I use.
Look at the peeps.
Starch.
Corn starch.
Baking soda.
Baking soda.
And coconut oil.
And coconut oil.
And an essential
oil. And an essential oil. All right. Kim, why you got all these scrunchies on your... I just
okay.
had to...
Cut the light on.
Okay, so this is her dress she picked. She tried it on yesterday. It looked real pretty. This supposed to be tied like that in the front.
Yeah, that's how it is.
Or it ties in the front.
Yeah.
But it's like it seems like it's real tight because these things come together like, yes. Like they could break or something. It's too tight.
They don't break.
They do break now.
Well,
it's kind of the texture. It's lined and black. She picked it out. It looked nice on her. So, yeah. Open it up, the belt.
It's twisted.
I know, it's gonna break. The string. Ain't no but a piece of thread. They sewed it and tacked it. I'm gonna edit all that out. How long it's taking you to do it? Okay. So you go around this way. Oh, it's two holes. Wait a minute. You got another hole right here and right there. Was it through this one?
I don't know.
Or put it through there so it won't be hanging. At least through the big one. So basically, it's got an opening right here, right? But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just tack it, well, pin it, put a little pin, and have it coming to right there. It's, yeah. And it's about whoever this person is. I don't know who JH is. It was $72, but it was on sale for $39 something. So, yeah.
Oh, it has a zipper right here.
I got a zipper too. You didn't know that yesterday.
Mm-mm. That's
pretty. It's a size 8. It's a size 8. And so, I told her she'd get one for graduation. And I got to get another from picture day. Like how she got one. This is a picture the outfit she had got for a picture day. So she decided that this is going to be her graduation dress. So what we try to do, we try to match. So the boys, well, Dada and the Sunny, I'm sure they're going to probably wear black and white. And us girls, us females, we're going to wear black and lamb or white and lamb. I got a lamb skirt. I think I still got that lamb skirt. Y'all remember?
Mm-hmm.
I might wear that.
Did you want to buy something new?
No, I don't want to buy nothing new, girl. I ain't got money like that. So, all I got to do is get her some shoes. Show them your accessories. I got her a necklace and some earrings from JCPenney. Oh, Monet. Ain't this,
Woman.
Well, one is M-O-N-A-E. I think, does she spell Samus like that? So this, her necklace. She got. And them little earrings that came with it. That's good for her ears. I don't even really know if I like how they blend, though. It look more greenish than lamb to me. But she said it all blend.
Exactly.
Well, the necklace do, but I don't know about the earrings. I don't know. We'll see. So I was on Amazon looking at some, so I'll see. Y'all know my go-to is Amazon. So I just got to get her some black shoes to go with this dress and maybe and another dress. We already saw another dress for picture day, I guess. They had some nice stuff. Or she could do a skirt and a blouse. Why your dress are always looking like some type of way, Shein? What you got to say for yourself? I'm going to throw my shoe at you. So that's that. And what else you get? Yeah. She walking around with that dress. She said she really love her dress. 1 through 10, what you get your dress?
I give it a 10.
You give it a 10? Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's show them the Bibles. We went and got the Bibles yesterday. Bibles are so expensive. Oh, y'all get stuff. Rain, you getting stuff on the mat? I just washed them. Why you take them off the table? Oh, where my foot? You gonna wash them? Who gotta wash? Well, you wash them when you wash.
No.
Yes. So it was regular price $24.99 on sale for $19.99. This Shein Bible. And New King James Version. It's nice. Camouflage. You wanna take it out the little thing? I got a writing now. I like the way this feel, y'all. Like a little patch. It feel good. So I gotta fill this in. Oh, you gotta fill that in. Oh, you can write this in.
Mm-mm. I don't
your name. Just that's for you to write.
It's for you. You did the other one in my other Bible.
I gave it to you. They normally have like a gift. Okay, y'all. Oh, here it go. Right here. I'm right on this part. Presented to by on this date. Your word. Okay, here go a message for y'all. Your word I have hidden in my heart. Psalms 119:11. You fill that in. They said, why should I read the Bible? That's interesting. So, yeah, that's Shein Bible. And we're reading the Bible. Mm-hmm. Now, I could throw these. I think this was Carrie Bible. Y'all see how raggedy that Bible is. Mm-hmm. I'm going to throw them away. I don't like throwing Bibles away. What am I going to eat for lunch? So this ring a Bible. You said you got a case for your Bible ring. Y'all can see my it's I like the texture. It's kind of soft and that like alligator skin type of situation, but it's soft. Holy Bible. I just got these yesterday. No, I'm on no grace, but thank you. I got it right in here. She got the King James Version. So yeah, the cover is pretty nice. Win a book of Amos. Yeah, and it's on me. Chapter 5. And this one we read. Yeah. Is this the... Oh, that's when I started out. It's on me again, ain't it? I think so. You don't write your new one in here?
Yes, on you.
Yeah. So, I ain't get the Sunny Bible. Cause, oh, where your case to your Bible at? You got her case. Oh, sorry. So her original price for her Bible was $27.99. It came to $20.99. And this had, look, Our Heritage and Faith Holy Bible for African American Teens. King James Version.
Mine is different from theirs.
Yeah, yours different.
That's mostly the same.
That's different words. New King James Version ain't that much different than King James Version. Mm-hmm. What you wanted me for, ring?
Do you want me to make you a pizza? Eat.
Are you gonna eat them?
You can have them. Y'all can have them. This is what she. Anyway. You only took. It's enough for. Yeah, this what she cooking that. Today. And she getting ready to make her
I'm cooking sweet potatoes too.
Sweet potato fries?
No, mashed potatoes.
Mashed potatoes. That's what I meant to say.
Coconut. Maybe some biscuits. I don't know.
It's my week. I have on my scripture. We just rip it. Marina had to write her today.
Wait, let me
and
see.
God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. Why you just, I could have just bothered us. You just like doing stuff. Yesterday they made them a pizza, which was really, really good. Sharon made me one. This Rena week to cook, so. She chicken breast and mashed potatoes. Tomorrow turkey burgers, and I don't like macaroni and cheese no more.
Me either, that's weird.
Pizza puff and fries. Sunday, I don't know what she gonna cook. But I think we're gonna need some more paper plates. And it's my week. I'm on kitchen duty this week, so. But the hubby, he washes them for me Thursday and Friday. Even though he know he do, but trying to act like he forget. So, yeah. We ain't got no projects we doing today.
So, we watching a movie.
What movie we watching? Y'all
Phantom
watching.
Phantom of the Opera.
Phantom of the Opera. You want to show the people your hair now?
Flat.
It don't matter. It's twisted. It get flat. Which when you like take it. It ain't like you're going to do a whole twist out.
You see it sticking up on that side.
That's what I told you putting in the ponytail.
Can you do it?
Yeah, but I just twisted it all over. And you stuff. She could. It looked nice. You could just pull it back. But that's gonna last while we on spring break. Cause I ain't trying to be doing no hair. So y'all, I guess that's about it. That's what's going on in my life today. On this Thursday. The hubby going to Aldi's to get some food. I gave him a list. The Sunny have a half a day today.
He'll be home in a little while. They just took that SAT test yesterday. He said it was 5.5 hours. Seriously? Oh, don't even get me started. But yeah, my hair's still in bantu knots up under here. I ain't took them out. They're starting to come loose though. They're starting to stick out. So I'm just keep it up under the sleep cap.
Where did that go?
So y'all, I'm gonna let y'all go. I'm finna go and put this, go on in, edit this video. And it's been raining. It ain't raining right now. Leaves, little branches stuff fell all on our porch and everything. It was so windy last night. I know I watched the news. They was talking about a tree fell on people's houses. Oh, it was so windy. Kyra came in. She was like, she said, address on the, you know how you had your number, your address on the front of the house. And our address got a 2 in it. And she said, something happening with y'all too. I'm like you gonna stay here an hour or two. So when the hubby left out last night, I said, Kyra here said something happened with the 2. I said, look and see what happened with the 2. He said, yeah, it's upside down. It's leaning to the left or something. I'm like, it's that windy. I was like, how just do that to our address number? For real, I ain't checked it out yet. But I'm gonna have him to fix it. I don't know if he gonna have to. I don't even know how it was up there. Nailed up there, glued up there. I don't know. So that's what he gonna have to do, fix it. We can't have no 2 leaning to the left. To the left, to the left, to the left. But yeah, yeah. So, Sharon, you can make me a pizza. Man, that pizza was good. And I really haven't been eating pizza because I be trying to stay away from all that grease and stuff. But since we made our own, it was okay because we used olive oil on it. And then you could kind of monitor what being put on there and everything. I wanted some onions on mine, but they told me I had no onion. What? I love onions, y'all. What? My purple onions, red onions, whatever kind of onion, whatever color you want to call it. I think they call them red onions, but they purple. I don't know. You do the math. I don't know why they do that, but them ones I really like. But no, I think I've been buying the white ones, white onions. It don't matter. I just love onions, for real, for real. I don't care. I just love onions on my food. And ain't nothing else really going on out there. I'm trying to see. Oh, I put up a layaway in Rainbow. I just get, it was complicated trying to get through some shirts. Oh, man, that's why I need to learn how to sew or something. Because JCPenney normally have the type of blouses and shirts I like for them. But they don't have layaway. And I normally get the bottoms from JCPenney, like capris or something. So I normally get the shirt from Rainbow and I just get them like 4 or 5 shirts a piece. But this year, everything is just so revealing, all open in the front. And I'm like, it was hard, cold shoulder type of shirts and stuff. I guess you want to, that's, I don't know, got the little hole right here and the shoulder showing. Not on my watch. We ain't trying to show all that flesh at no 13 or 14 years old. Grown, that's different. But I'm not with my girls being exposed all like that. And they ain't no little girls. So, no. And the hubby don't play that. Like, when I buy graduation dresses and stuff, he gotta, like, have give his, even though he don't go in when we pick them, but I always have to keep in mind, like, he real old-fashioned like that. He don't, nah. Even though they kind of thick and some stuff just gonna fit, but short skirts and dresses. No, all that revealingness. No, he ain't playing that. You know, I could get caught up in the fashion of it and be like, ooh, this cute. You know, I don't really sometimes when thinking all about the revealing too much part. And when he look at it, he like, you let them pick that out? I'm like, what you mean? I'm like, he just offended me. I feel like a bad mother. So now I just really be super conscious when we going, because he always, I don't drive, so he drive me everywhere, but he don't go into them stores. He can't hang like that. So he be like, we at home, we show him. It used to be a time with the older ones. I'd be like, damn, I wonder what he gonna say about this. Because I had to get with the program. Because I didn't wear revealing clothes myself, but that's the type of stuff that's kind of be out here. But I be still trying to say, oh, well, this ain't that bad. He'll look at it like, uh-uh, no, it's that bad. I'm like, really? And be ready to argue about it because I know I feel kind of like, I be feeling like this little, but know I'm wrong. I take it back. I used to have to take stuff back all the time, y'all, for real. But now, because I like fashion, and I like the little shoulder things, but I'm like, he ain't going to even have that with Rena. Rena, no, no. They had I had a lot of little dresses like that. It was cute too, but I'm like, nah. So that's why that little opening, it got to get pinned up. And normally, I think I don't think he gonna say too much about it that the arm out. Cause normally you have to get like a shrug or something. We'll see when she tried on and let him see. Cause she tried it on yesterday, he was asleep. So we'll see if we gonna have to get a shrug to go with that dress. I don't know. So, yeah. See, you did something with it and everything, cause he don't play that, y'all. So I have to be careful about shoes. No, not no real high heels. You know, not on our watch. Just put it like that. Now, when they get grown, it ain't saying he be all comfortable with all that, cause he definitely ain't about no cleavage showing, seeing none of that. But some. You know, when they get grown, hey, they buy their own clothes and they ain't staying with you. What can you say? But it is what it is. He just have to swallow that. You know, they ain't going nowhere with me looking like that. But I get it. I had to get there, y'all. Because at first I'm like, man, you make a big deal about everything. But I understand that's them being female. I didn't grow up with no men over me and no dad caring about what I put on. My mama, it was what it was. I could dress however I wanted to dress. Cause she dressed it her way anyway. She was some of the stuff I was wearing some of her clothes. Cause the way how her dresses was made. But by me being raised in church, it was kind of hard. My grandmama didn't play that. I tried to come up in there with a shirt open. She kept safety pins for me. It's like she knew. Now being an adult and being a mom, she was waiting on me. She probably already knew. She gonna try it. She gonna try to walk up in this little church with her little shirt with them little three buttons not buttoned up. I got her or say it ain't no button. I got pins for her, cause I walk up in there, you know, after church, cause I used to catch the bus to church. I stayed on one side of town, but when I got to the age to travel, I used to catch the bus on my own to the church. And I walk up there, church been started already, and she like, I'm like, oh my goodness, you know, I live in the projects, you know, I was about that life. My grandmama like, not up in this church. Come here. She was seriously peeing my shirts up. Yeah, and that just kind of stuck with me. So when I did finally get grown, because I was like a teenager and stuff, going to church all the time, like 11 on up. So when I did step out there like that, I ain't get out there too bad. I still was never about the chest revealing and all that. Still ain't. You know, like some stuff just be cut low. But I have to be careful because the hubby don't play that either. So I have to be watchful and mindful of that. Because it ain't about me. You know, I'm a kept woman. I'm a married woman. I have to be careful how I... And it's all about your husband, though. Because some husbands probably don't even care about stuff like that. But I'm telling you, I have a husband from the South. Born in Mississippi. He's Southern. He cares about those type of details like that. About your brush on and... stuff being up too short. And I don't think it's about no insecurity, because men's, it's not about insecurities with men. Women kind of get in their feelings about that. That's just his perception. That's just his that's his way, and I had to respect that and everything. So it was kind of a little semi struggle in the end. He from the project, I'm from the project, so he knew about that project life, but he didn't want no woman out there like that. So I had to, like, he only let me wear my lipstick and my makeup. He didn't care too much about that. I stopped that on my own. He didn't care about my earrings and stuff like that, or nothing like that. But he was serious about the dress and just how you present yourself. And I get that, because that's a God thing in the Bible too. So even if he hadn't, even if he hadn't came at me with it, I think I probably would have got there anyway, because reading the Bible, it's all up in there how a woman should wear, how she should dress, and how she should conduct herself, and all that type of stuff. So, eventually, I would have conformed anyway, you know, but I was never like, I didn't never really had a loose type of spirit on me, so to speak, like that. That's why I kind of call it. And he would call it slutty. That was his favorite word, slut, like, type. That's the word he used to use all the time, just from growing up in the projects and stuff and seeing certain women dressing and acting a certain way. So yeah, but and so he definitely don't play that with our girls, and I get it. I don't even want my girls out here dressing like that. I want them to be covered, not looking like a nun or no offense, the ones that cover their whole bodies and just have their ass on and stuff. Not that serious, but presentable. You know what I'm saying? Because the beauty is in the eye of the beholder and stuff. So, I believe that as a female. So, I kind of done took on a lot of his way of thinking. That's weird, but I have. Coming from a man, I had to get there. I had to understand some everything he be on. I don't understand everything, cause like we still be having like clash with issues with some things we do with the kids, some things we don't. Like, I'm a little more lenient with things. I said patient with things than he is. I think that's where the more his tolerance level is really low. With nonsense, but I have to be like, calm down, it's okay, you know. Like, he be ready to put everybody out. I'm like, come on now, can't do that. They got nowhere to go. Have a kid's homeless. They make him mad. They gotta go. These are cats. I mean, some people don't even do their cats like that. But you would think like that with an animal. An animal will tear up your stuff, and you be like, get out, you know. But come on, these kids, these human beings. I have to calm them down in that type of area. But yeah, y'all. It was really like when you got to come together with another person and spend the rest of your life with they way of thinking, and y'all got to kind of find some like compromise, some kind of like balance and compromise about situations, because it could become a tug of war. And I mean, seriously, that was a real thing, especially having four kids that wasn't his and that step parenting thing. Man, I feel like we made it through that. We could make it through anything, for real, for real. And dealing with baby mamas and all that type of stuff. We done came over that whole, like, the camel hump, the mountain hump. So now, any kind of issues that kind of come up now, we good, you know. I'm basically to the point where if it's really something serious that kind of come out our way with one of the kids, mostly it'd be kids situations, especially with me having a lot of girls and stuff, I have to kind of be like, okay, now, wait a minute. Yeah, I think you're doing too much. You're saying too much. Because I'm still kind of like real sensitive when it comes to my kids, and especially my girls and everything, you know. And it is a difference between boys and girls, and I get that. But due to that I don't have two boys, I think I'm kind of more like a softie when it comes to my son. And he be like, well, you going to be a man one day. I get that. But he ain't a man now. That one day is inedible, but he ain't a man now. Okay. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. You know, let me enjoy where I'm at. You know? So, yeah, we have to, you know, them type of situations. But with me and him, we good. We know each other likes and dislikes. We there with each other. It's just still we kind of clash with these kids sometimes. It don't be like no real big thing, cause ain't too much new popping up. But if it do, I kind of know how to approach him. I know how to talk to him and everything. I kind of know what bothers him. Yeah. And hey, you help making my pizza. Man, I ain't know I had no onions. I could have picked up some when we went to Walmart yesterday. I forgot to tell Dad I had to get an onion. I get it tomorrow when I go out. When we go get the grandbabies. So yeah. You come to interrupt me while I make my video and be rude. You gotta lean. It's already leaning. I'm trying to get a position. So yeah, this is it right here. The sleek cap. What you doing to my eye? What? But yeah, so bear with me today, y'all. Today Thursday, and it's just one of these days. I ain't feel like taking off my sleep cap because my things getting loose and they doing the most. And I didn't feel like putting no earrings in. And I didn't feel like putting no scarf on my head. I just didn't feel like it today because I wore myself out yesterday at the mall. Yes, I did. And, just walking around looking for a dress, man. Then they rearranged everything like in JCPenney. They had the dresses in places they normally didn't have. And after I bought the dress, I forgot I had to get the necklace. And I had to go right back in there and look for a necklace. It was hard to find a lamb necklace. But that's what she found. But I'm not really feeling that one. So I went on Amazon last night and I looked up some. And I kind of like, I seen a couple of them that I like. I don't know if I'm going to order them or not. Or we just going to do that one. But that's kind of greenish. I want lime. Right? And so, yeah. I might order it off Amazon. I don't know. Oh, and I order my grandbaby a give me that little pop-up pamper. It's right there. Since you sitting here, Rain.
I love you, Madre.
That this girl right here though.
Hmm?
I be through homeschooling in 4 years, dog. It came today. We opened it up. I got this from my grandbaby's room and stuff. Well, yeah. It's just a document stuff, and that's their thing. So I'm gonna take it over there tomorrow. I forget how much it was. It was $8 and something. $8.99 or something like that on Amazon. So, yeah, I'm trying to, like, order them little stuff for their rooms here and there and stuff. So, yeah. But, y'all, I've been talking to y'all long enough, and I'm about sure sharing what I'm going to do with my pizza and everything. And, like I said, we ain't doing, no projects and stuff. We taking a break, and they going to watch a movie, Phantom of the Opera. That's one of my favorite movies. I used to watch that so much. I think I gave that movie away, though. Oh, that's the movie Phantom of the Opera. Who is that? Who played the Phantom? Was that Gerard Butler?
Yeah.
Gerard Butler played, and I ain't even really know him back then, but cause they keep it like a little mask on half of his face and all that type of stuff. But I think I'm gonna watch that with them. I haven't seen it in years. Yeah, so I love my little singing movies. And my daughter said she went to see Beauty and the Beast, child number two. And she said it was real good. And I'm like, man. But I'm going to wait for it to come on Showbox. Yeah, and I watched that. She said it's like 2 hours and something long. But I'm kind of anxious to kind of see that too. And Fate Furious. I can't wait till that come out. But yeah, y'all. I'm just kind of, I ain't had no sugar. Nope. Y'all think I'm on the sugar high, but no, this just me. I can talk when I find something to really talk about. And movies, kids, marriage, Jesus. Hey, we could be here all. No, we can't, because my battery, my camera can't even hang with me if I really start flowing like that, y'all. Don't even let me bring music into it. Oh, snap. On that note, y'all, I'm going to let y'all go. And I hope everybody enjoy their Thursday. Have a blessed Thursday, a safe Thursday, and a productive Thursday. And thank you for hanging with me, keeping me company till I get ready to eat this pizza. It's a little round pizza. It ain't that big, so I'm not being greedy today. So, on that note, y'all, I'm out. Tell them, Shan, we'll come after. I'm out.
Peace.
Mm-hmm.
And love.
And?
Share some.
And?
I'll holler.
Bye, y'all. See y'all Saturday. Ooh. Or Sunday.